Hello and welcome to another Mario Party 6 minigame review. Today we're reviewing Lunartix, a dual minigame.
Yep, this is our second dual minigame we've reviewed in a row.
Was it as good as the last one?
I actually did find it pretty enjoyable. It's one of those ones that's really short, but I feel like it works for a dual minigame. You don't want these to go on too long.
I agree. And just like the last dual minigame, it still had that really nice level of tension you want in a dual minigame.
Yeah, basically you're both trying to land your spaceship as close to zero as you can, and whoever gets closer to that time wins. So it's a pretty simple one, and one that doesn't take that long to play. But like I said, that's okay for a dual minigame, and it's still pretty enjoyable to play.
I agree, there was a nice strategy in this one to figure out where you should break if you wanted to do it right away and hold it down, and then just fastly float to the bottom, or if you wanted to do it a little bit throughout, or hold it right at the bottom. You kind of figure out what strategy worked best for you and try different things each time.
Yeah, I would usually fall about half of the way down and then start braking to get as close as I could without landing. You're always slightly falling, even when you're braking, so you don't want to get too close to the ground because then you won't be able to stay up. But you don't want to be too far away when it reaches zero, otherwise it'll take you too long to land. Another thing we found out is that when you're trying to land as close to zero as you can, even if you land after it reaches zero, you can still be closer to the other person because negative times count.
Oh yeah, that was really interesting. I didn't think it would count, but it did!
Yeah, I feel like it was a nice touch. And overall, I feel like this minigame's just pretty nice in general. Like we said, this one's short and sweet, but it works for a dual minigame. When only two of the players are playing, you don't want these to go on for too long. But as far as dual minigames go, this is a good one. It's got that tension you want, and there's definitely a good amount of strategy involved as you're trying to land your ship. It's not one of the all-time classics, but we enjoyed playing it. We're giving it 4 stars out of 5.
Well, that's it for today. If you enjoyed this review, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell. Up next, we'll be reviewing Mass Meteor. Wait, another dual minigame?
Wow, 3 in a row.
I hope it keeps up the pattern of 4 stars.
Oh, really? I actually kind of hope it's a 5-star, but yeah, I guess if you want a 4-star, that's good.
Wait, I take it back. I want a 5-star. We haven't had one yet.
Well, you might have just jinxed us. But if you want to see how this minigame is, come back for our next video.
Hope to see you then.